Can you explain what haydutsila means?
Haydutsila, translated into English, is thought, thinking, thought polishing, thought refining, and the final product of that thought. Haydutsila doesn't stop there. It's not just a final product. Anybody on the other side of the mountain or the other side of the ocean who has their window open, you can throw haydutsila with your thought and they'll get it instantly. And they know your window's open, now they can think a thought right back to you. Better an instant email. Haydutsila. I open up my email and look for haydutsila. Half the time somebody wants to sell me a truck of hay for my horses or something. I don't quite understand haydutsila yet, but they will. That's all I know about haydutsila.
You mentioned salmon. So throughout northern and central California, in the rivers that aren't already too blocked by dams, the salmon have been at a record low due to human habitat destruction and overfishing. Along the Eel River in Northern California near Willits, the Round Valley tribes made ceremonies this year to welcome back the salmon for the first time in 100 years. And this year, the Chinook salmon were at the highest level that they've been in many years. So I'm wondering if you have something to say about the salmon.
Yes, in the very beginning, in the first day, I just mentioned salmon because the valley now is empty. A little river running. San Joaquin Valley has a little river running compared to the volume that was there before. And Nick Adell, one of the great dreamers and creators in our narratives. He made from Tekedo Hidachi, from the center of the earth, which is right in my homeland. Just accidentally, maybe, but that's where it is. He made a river up through the mountains and across the valleys. And it's it Ajuma in the language. English people have been calling it Pitt River ever since 1858. Before that, it was Itachuma. And he made a place there where Itachuma comes by. So the Ijoti runs out and drops right in to Itachuma. Then they join and go down the big canyon over there to a nice little flat. And then the Hat Creek runs down, joins them there. It's almost Tekedo Hidachi, almost where those rivers and creeks come together. there is a nice flat rock. The river rock is still in the river, pretty good size. Matter of fact, we lived within a mile of it, built our house there when we went home. But it was on that rock where Nick Dell first sang a song to the salmon to welcome it into the river and up into the homeland, with the intention of the salmon being a food for the people, food for the bear, food for the wolverine, food for the old coyote, food for ants, food for things in the ocean, water, river, food for the whole landscape, and help the trees and everything. That's what they did. Came up. But Nick Dell stood on that big round rock. And when this salmon, this kind, came this way, the Chinook salmon, he said, you go up and spawn up Hat Creek country. They went to Hat Creek country. Here come the silver salmon. You go to Fall River. The falls, that's the big falls at Fall River. Spawn there. They all went there to spawn. Here come the sea-going trout, the steelhead. He said, okay, you go to Bernie, it's called Bernie Falls now, but its real name is Jemma Wehelo Tuiji. You go to Jemma Wehelo Tuiji. Spawn there. So they did. Went to spawn there. And then he sang a song. And he laid it on the water. And it went off rippling down the river to the ocean. That song was a welcome song for salmon forever after. So it's not surprising that the song has that intense power yet. If the song comes from the heart, it has an intense amount of power. So more salmon coming. Probably they really need it to be welcome, because they're not only neglected, they're attacked and damaged all of their life. Somebody's trying to catch them in a big 30-foot net out in the ocean. Somebody's shooting them with a rifle when they get close. Everything else they have to live through. Barbed wire coming down a river, so they got to go shore around the barbed wire. They get pretty damaged trying to get home to spawn. But it's really nice that somebody welcomed the salmon. I'd like to hear the song. It must be in the old language. We're supposed to sing to the salmon. We're supposed to dream dreams with salmon. We're supposed to do a lot of things that we don't in this age of fast food and everything instant. We hardly ever take time to do what we're supposed to do, and we are supposed to make very important contact with nature all of the time. That's all I know about salmon and songs.